became you know, a great torso. Onye ga anoni ya. Can you find Ammon Melo? Ammon fell in love with his half sister. Some of us will commit incest. He fell in love with the half sister. Alo. And from that day, he started planning, devising a means to sleep with his half sister. He made several attempts, but the half sister refused. Tamar, the half sister called Tamar. And the scripture says, Ammon became obsessed. He was obsessed with Tamar, that he became ill. Tamar was still a virgin. But one day, Jonadab saw Ammon. He was restless and ill. Makawan wele for cholo. Only wetaro. And Jonadab asked him, "What is your problem, sir?"
I'm obsessed.
And Jonadab advised him wrongly. Jonadab told him, "Now you know what you're gonna do. You have to pretend as if you are ill." And he made a request that Tamar should take care of you. I will say, yes. That is a nice strategy. Or pretend they are gonna run there. I see David in a radio aqua Ammon. Or that's a fear. Grandma Tama will call that if you shall. Of course, Nico Butalia, the devil also, who met a friend and his ever, oh, Gidano Waka, Pedumuda, because Russia Bokuno and Atom, go with the Vienso, and Chawa. Oh, my dear. He disversioned her his half sister Tamar. He were upswollen because Tamar was the sister of Absalom. Absalom the Bunambobologin Agum Pafia de Nauko. Well, so you say, I must kill this bagger. Oh, once a time he got him eliminated. There's no other way to book at Archu. He's a long way. Why are you well? You are to the David inherited a curse. He attracted, he did not inherit a curse, rather, he attracted a curse upon himself. My age will be your rear. I'm up on a tap on a beggy. Archu Salakun is in on here. Well, sopo ocheze, asopo okwa, onye gabweze nezinu no. Onye gabweze, isi onye gabweze, mbangwa, ebugo, Ammon. Jesu Christi me elanye bere.
Virgin Maria nyeranya.
When you go to 2 Samuel chapter 13, you read it very, very well. Beware of the company you keep. Remember the story of Rehoboam in 2 Chronicles chapter 10. When you go there, you read the story of Rehoboam. Rehoboam succeeded the father Solomon, but he was deceived. Instead of him to hearken to the counsels of the elders, he decided to take counsel to listen to the ungodly, his friends. I always say, don't allow your friends to influence your new position. Don't allow your friends to influence you. For you to retain that relationship, maybe you are getting something from the relationship. And you are supporting your friend even when your friend is doing evil, perpetrating evil in the society. Jesus Christ,
Virgin Maria,
and that led to in 2 Chronicles chapter 10. That led to a heavy split between the southern and the northern kingdom. What share have we in David? Do you attend to all Israel? Even when the elders came came to advise him, the little boy Rehoboam, his friends confused him. Don't allow your friends to confuse you. Don't allow your friends to influence your home. Don't allow your friends to influence you negatively. There are people who are called vision terminators. They do that out of jealousy. At the same time, there are people called vision appreciators. They will appreciate you. You are good plan. That's your wonderful plan. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Ahithophel also advised this man, Absalom, wrongly. It was Ahithophel that told Absalom, do you know what you do to pay your father? And Absalom said, no, 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 no. Now, you have to gather your father's concubine. You have to gather your father's concubine. Gather all of them and sleep with them. And Absalom slept with his father's concubine 200 in a day. Netiti ibalang oma ibenenenu tentinenu. Jesu neranya bere.
Jesu maranya ranya ka.
A cupboard. A cupboard. A cupboard. A cupboard. In 1 Samuel chapter 4. Open your Bible again. 1 Samuel chapter 4. And see where we drafted this message of a cupboard. This a cupboard message. Verse 19 of 1 Samuel chapter 4, the scripture says, Eli's daughter-in-law, the wife of Phinehas, was pregnant and near her time of delivery. When she heard that the ark of God had been captured and that her father-in-law and husbands were dead, she went into labor and gave birth. She died in childbirth. But before she passed away, the midwife tries to encourage her. Don't be afraid, they said. You have a baby boy. But she did not answer or pay attention to them. She named the child Ichabod, which means, where is the glory? For she said, Israel's glory is God. Child of God, you must ask yourself today, where is your glory? Are you a cupboard? Remember, the very day Samson slept with Delilah, the Shekinah glory evaporated. Samson became a cupboard. This child, the wife of Phinehas, was pregnant. And due to, you know, he had her baby prematurely. He had her baby. He got the news that the husband, the husband and the female has, that they had been killed in the war front. At the war front. And the moment he got the news, she delivered the baby prematurely. When the midwives were trying to console her, don't worry, the child is alive. Where then is the glory of Israel? Since they have captured the Ark of Covenant. And when Eli the high priest heard the bad news, he also shouted, the glory of our land had gone. That's why he slumped and died. That brought to an end the death of this man, Eli the high priest. He lacked parental responsibility. When you lack in your duty, you are when you are parental, I call it parental irresponsibility, because there are certain things you ought to do or you ought to have done when that child was still a baby and you didn't do it. You were passive about his spiritual life or her spiritual life. Oh, yeah, but I ought to wear Kaliako. On a bone measure, measure Tinelia, or sis steak, Bomboka, the Nangwa, Obon or Kaloako, just like what is happening nowadays. Umaga de Joka, Ibinia Jaboka,
inatu kata anolo yasa anolo iyara juha ijegu katata.
Think about that.
Ibidiye ufali abe ibidiye abe onha menka ngwa menka menka kanje money mass.
Eto tamo amo muntonite
me ya oka baso kana aluko. Of course aluko no ezuru no nke ma aluko bu.
Yeah.
Mbano otuti onya so age bulu onwe ori bana da akako
aboye nto obosi a muko obun Jesu mera ni ebere
veji maria nyara anya ka.
Look at Eli. Hophni and Phinehas died in one day. Eli died and the wife of Phinehas gave birth prematurely. Where is the glory? Ichabod, the glory has departed. Oh my God,
child of God, where is your glory? Where is your glory? Can there be na foto onwe gi? Can there be na foto onwe gi wa chukwu? Is that glory of God still intact in your life? Remember what the scripture says in Isaiah chapter 49 verse 3. You are my son, you are my daughter, in whom I will be glorified. Oye mercy ni awe na lo tito. Foundation was destroyed. What can they just do? This month is our month of intimacy with God. Intimacy means what? Authentic and unadulterated relationship with God. I love the boy Samuel. I said it again. I say it again. When you are intimate with the Master Jesus, Christ will always make a way for you. Christ will always fight all your battle. Because the scripture says, come closer to me and I will come closer to you. Okay, Kesege, you had a promised child of God. Christ of Ogenania, David said, and I loved you, your best of all. You have loved me with an everlasting love.
What is happening in your life today? The little boy Samuel. Even when Hophni and Phinehas had gone to bed, Eli had gone to bed, and what happened? The little boy Samuel was at the sanctuary. Then the scripture says, when you go to the book of Samuel, in 1 Samuel chapter 3, the scripture says, in those days, visions were uncommon, and the messages from the rare, were from the Lord, were very, very rare. Who can tell me the reason? Even the priests of God at that time no longer received the message from the Lord because they were busy talking about the ceremonial priesthood. They were busy fighting one another. They were busy castigating even a fellow prophet. Even when they were busy jealousing one another, and the scripture recorded that the messages from the Lord were very, very rare, and the visions were quite uncommon. But the young boy Samuel was at the sanctuary. The young boy Samuel had an intimate relationship with God, and that's why God called Samuel. God is looking for Samuel. He called you out. Ikilu olu ebube akara wa gugoro Holy Ghost adoration man o kan acho Samuel o were Samuel o acho o kan acho Samuel gawo sana sanctuary ko we olu olu ebube o kan acho o le mo sheke fire o le mo fire 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 fire.
I release the anointing for medical freedom for you.
Amen.
I release the power of freedom for you.
Amen.
Anointing for all of freedom for you.
Amen.
Financial hekegabu. Fire! I release the anointing and the power of freedom for you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Stand up wherever you are. Raise your right hand up. Month of intimacy.
with God. Revelations from the Lord, we are very, very rare. Visions, we are quite uncommon. Because the light of intimacy had gone. The fire of intimacy had gone. As some of us, devil has rendered us a cupboard. The glory has departed. When you act again, your glory must come back.
Amen.
Your glory must come back.
Amen.
Your power must come back.
Amen.
Your glory must come back.
Amen.
Your power must come back.
Amen.
Your glory must come back.
Amen.
Your power must come back.
Amen.
Your power must come back.
Amen.
Your power must come back.
Amen.
I command every lost glory to return. Can you call Jesus Abia? By making a new year resolution. He can't believe him with you today. Our brothers has implored, Father, give me another chance. May the lost glory come back.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Place your hand on your neighbor's head. Neighbor, I command the lost glory.
I command the Lord's glory
to come back.
Neighbor,
I command the Lord's glory.
I command the Lord's glory
to come back.
Neighbor,
your Lord's glory shall come back.
Your Lord's glory shall come back.
Neighbor, your Lord's blessing shall come back. Your blessing shall manifest. This month your blessing shall manifest. This month your breakthrough shall manifest. This month your blessings must manifest. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Do the sign of the cross. Power, Holy Ghost confirm. Anointing take over. Power, Holy Ghost confirm. Power, Holy Ghost confirm. Power, Holy Ghost confirm. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Can you let Mary be seated? Open your Bible to the Gospel of Matthew chapter 5. I would like us to look at the eight ways. Let us look at the eight ways of God's blessing. Eight ways of blessedness. That is the beatitude. For you to develop an intimate relationship with Lord Jesus Christ, you must listen to the words of the beatitude. Number one, you must be conversant with the Eucharist. You better write these things down. You must be conversant with the Eucharist. According to St. Thomas Aquinas, when you eat the Eucharist, you become the person you received. What you are seeing here is our Lord Jesus Christ present in the blessed Eucharist. When you receive the Eucharist, you become what you receive. You become whom you receive. 1 John 4:4, he who is in you is better than he who is in the world. Sitting in a tool, Lady Asso, I am not getting a tenon so. Ah, look up. Now, why should I buy Canon and Job, Larola, Jauka, Emanatolili? Obu, the man, John Dukasukuno, go to a priest and confess your sins. This month, you must confess. Some of us here, for almost a year and day, we have not gone to confession, and we are talking about intimacy with God. Your carriage is a symbol of Christ's love. Through the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, you have a covenant of blessing and protection. Amen and amen.
Amen.
The Eucharist is a symbol of Christ's love. How can you claim to be an adorer, a redeemed child of God, without the Eucharist? Odika onye na-enwere ọbara. Odika mmadụ ọbara na-adị ọsị n'arụ. Where is the glory then? Kakimlo the Catholic Church, kuzi lani fuli biaso na abalani. In Kembo, one of the banning son of Jesus Christ, and that is the intimate we are talking about. In Kembo, one of the banning son of Jesus Christ, and that is the intimate we are talking about. In Kito, one of the battle I only want to agree in Joe. Only got to avoid sin. In Kino, or the Nani Gini, in Benton, only the son of Goya. Oh, we go to Natalia with Feto, Goya. Oh, then no, but me up the decrepit all the way from Enugu orthopedic. Only the answer can you hear? Oh, okay, but I'm about to tell him for a bit on and ask for Enugu. Now, how soon? Now, what can I do? I drag it. Can be because of I can see Kavanazia. Oh, what I want to hear to know, Mr. Cianaro. Oh, what you open and I told you, or say yes, sir, and where's in the Butalia Fapo? Nyama Boni is the first and last person in the communion during consultation. Nwalo Siangwa, you had a confession. After the confession, Nwega na Tabanako, Weto Liliasa, Eche Agunzei, Eche Fetolis Pekatamundi, Beati Feda Chena Magini Vokate Suntu. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, Nyabo Dogu. Odogu akataka na odogu akabaka. Owa aturo ode bota polonjo nkuwa. We are privileged. Ani werisi oma bondi akbala na olili nke maturo chineke. Onu obu na akbala na olili ya. You are privileged. Remember what the scripture says upon Mount Zion. In the book of Isaiah 25. Yahweh Sabaoth will prepare a banquet of joy for you. Oh banquet ye kane si pambe pambe. Nwasi aru kiso na to olili ya. Ebuli ya naba. Tupu ya ne huu. Oh no, we're getting a little banana. Odiko magic. Can you come and look magic? Zoyale ba. What's that last one? Bro, imagine. Ma zoyale. For the months of your career, no. For several months, I want to tell you something. Una marani neba nuwa. Then, but later into the California, maybe you are joking with the power of Eucharist. Be not taught and that only there's a new so question like question if you fall the marriage. Catechism of the Catholic Church, Jose, or Madon Chakon and many people in India, and the scripture said, no, it is only those who receive them in a worthy manner. St. Paul will say, salus male, salus boni, sota etamen in equality. The good and the bad, they came to receive, but they go home with what? Different fruits. Amen and amen.
Amen.
The Eucharist. The word of God. The second point is the word of God. When you begin to read the word of God, Jesus Christ will appear. I'm telling you out of experience. Jesus Christ will appear. Remember what happened in Gospel of Luke chapter 24. On their way to the Emmaus, the two disciples, Peter and Cleopas, the moment they started sharing the word of God, what happened? Jesus Christ appeared and joined them. And they were breaking the word. And as they were breaking the word, there was a new fire burning in their hearts about the salvation, about this man Jesus Christ. In fact, a little commentary said that they had instant parousia here on earth, just like our brother Stephen. When he saw the glory of God, he saw Jesus Christ sitting at the right hand of the Father. And that's what happened on their way to the Emmaus. And that's why when Jesus Christ disappeared after breaking the bread, look at their testimony. And they said, oh, when he was talking to us, our hearts were filled with fire. When he was breaking the word, we had an experience of the resurrected Jesus in action. We had the passion for evangelization. We felt the fire. Oh, no wonder. Child of God, I want to tell you, no wonder St. Paul calls the word of God the sword of the Spirit. If you are here and you find it difficult to read the word of God, something is lacking. You cannot have an intimate relationship with Jesus Christ. something is lacking. You need to marry your Bible. You need to read your Bible. You need to pray through the Psalms. By so doing, there is what is called transformation by beholding. As you are reading the word of God, St. Jerome tells us that there are angels of God in charge of every word in the scripture. That's why when you are reading the word of God, that word is taking flesh, and that is your miracle. Wonder somebody.
Amen.
Raise your Bible up. Father, I bless your word again. Father, let there be a new fire of transformation.
Amen.
Fire of miracles and signs and wonders.
Amen.
In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Raise your divine touch up. Father, as they are reading the divine touch this month, I prophesy miracle.
Amen.
Every day, oh Lord, may they be renewed. Amen. From one glory to another glory.
Amen.
Let there be a sudden and a mighty power, metamorphosis of spirituality in their lives.
Amen.
Father, let there be a change. Every day, oh Lord, let there be a new miracle in their lives.
Amen.
A new miracle in their mouth.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The word of God. Intimate relationship. Month of intimacy. Now let us look at the words of Jesus Christ. The 8 ways of blessedness. Because intimacy with Jesus Christ elicits miracle. Am I communicating here?
I hear you.
It elicits favor. If you are here and you want extraordinary blessing, you must be intimate with our Lord Jesus Christ. If you want extraordinary favor, because the spiritual controls the physical. In 2 Corinthians 10 verse 3 and 4, it is true that we walk in the flesh, but we do not war in the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. They are mighty. Capable of pulling down stronghold and casting slots to any negative power that raises itself against the glory of the Almighty God. Oh, my people, anybody that is attacking your blessing, I release the fire of vengeance.
Amen.
Through the word of God in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Matthew chapter 5. Carry your Bible and stand up. The message is coming to an end now. Intimacy with Jesus Christ. Remember our topic, dealing with your Ichabod. Today, you must deal with your Ichabod.
Amen.
Church, you couldn't know. Think about it. That the Master Jesus came and died for us. And after that, you live as if nothing happened. Let me tell you, Christ Jesus left for us a legacy. He left a legacy to be emulated. He left for us a legacy. He left for us a mighty power or blessing. But I don't know where you are today. Where are you? Where is that glory? Phinehas' wife asks, where is the glory? Has the glory departed? The glory must come back. Matthew chapter 5. Actually, I'm going to come back. This month, we can end the corner. So, give me any way, man. Hey! The end of the corner. So, are you giving up today? Now, the master, this is. And you see the power of God in action. Avoid ungodly relationship. I used to say it all the time. Oh well, if he can go, oh well, even if he can go, I read. Matthew chapter 5 verse 3 following. And he began to teach them. God blesses those who are poor and realize their need for him, for the kingdom of God is theirs. That is the poor in the spirit. You are poor, but when you see your neighbor progressing, when your neighbor is flourishing, you are never happy. And you will never be blessed. You can't be blessed. You can't have your own money. Let me tell you, if you want God's blessing, if you want that thing that is happening to your friend to happen to you, what you have to do is what? Tap that blessing. Appreciate God's blessing in the life of your neighbor, even if it is spiritual gift. Are they with you in our obey on the microphone, cut all your fellow preacher because you are afraid. I don't imagine it. Are they with you in our ministries? Onye bo onye ya sanya bo oku Jesus na ele anya bere
Feji Maria nyere anya aka
If you man na mele wanna gi appreciate God's blessing in the life of your neighbor and ask God for your own blessing. I tell you, by so doing, God, your best about oath, because of your goodwill and heart, will make that blessing abound in your life. Try that. It was in Anyoku. Why would you think that you would be? Why are you here? Watch. One day, your friend and Aluna. Why do you want to keep in your canal to your letter? You see me according to my. Some of us, out of jealousy, you go even to the extent of conniving with kidnappers to kidnap your friend. And they convince the kidnapper that your friend has what? Enough money to pay the ransom. You are simply a wicked man. You may want to take on war. Amen.
Amen.
I seen another lower even more. And there's a new grab in Kesha. Ndi anapolo ube ni mbembe we pibon zona bro. Eba we ino. Ni mbembe attribute all the blessings to Christ. Oh, Jesus Christ we ike ni ine. Attribute all the blessings to him. Jesus ngi we ike ni ine. Jesus ife mani ine adini adim masi ne na gini. Na kaga abia. O nwe ge ife abu ni inwe lo. Nwe umana. Why must you victimize or intimidate the poor? Oh, no, but you're not going to argue. Nali ane ya. Ha! Hey, Psalm 12, tina kena si. Nga ba span kita nanya milu mo bine. Kedo ne ti mo bine, akwa mani ajan. Obe kwa kwa agama anu kwa. Obu no obe kwa kwa agama megeri. Agama anu kwa. Ah! Jesu mera anya bere.
Fiji mara anya ranya ka.
God blesses those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Kedo anya ba ne ruju. Aga kasi gogi. God blesses those who are humble, for they will inherit the whole earth. Meek and the humble of heart, the human, they will inherit the earth. God blesses those who hunger and thirst for justice, for they shall be satisfied. God blesses those who are merciful, for they shall be shown mercy. God blesses those who has appeal, for they will see God. God blesses those who work for peace, for they shall be called children of God. Saint Francis of Assisi prayed, God, make me an instrument of peace. Where there is strife, let me sow love. God, make me an instrument of peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. As a child of God, you must make yourself an instrument of peace. Where there is hatred, may God use you as a symbol of love. Where there is, you know, katakata pandemonium, may God use you as a symbol of peace. Pray that God will use you as a symbol of unity and the peace. Everybody here, you have a mandate. That fracas in your husband's house. You have the mandate to unite everybody. Let there be peace. Let love and peace lead. In verse 10, the scripture says, God blesses those who are persecuted for doing right, for the kingdom of God is theirs. God blesses you when people mock you and persecute you and lie about you and say all sorts of evil things against you because you are my follower. Be happy about it. Be very glad, for a great reward awaits you in heaven. I stand here to tell you, not only in heaven, but what? On earth. When people blackmail you, when they level all sorts of allegations against you, and you are righteous, let me tell you, rejoice, because God will give you worldwide reputation and the blessing. They can't stop you, because your God has not stopped you. They can never intimidate you and suppress you, since you are righteous. Righteousness is your foundation. Righteousness will be the fire that will fight your battle. You don't need to cry. People has even every right to castigate you, but Jesus Christ has a final say in Psalm 2. The word of God says, he who sits in the heaven laughs. Authentic and intimate relationship with God. You are beatitude lies your blessing. When you love Christ and when all these problems start coming, just know that they are for your blessing. I remember what happened in Gospel of Luke, chapter 10, about Martha and the Mary. The day Jesus was visited the house of Martha and Mary, Martha was there running around, you know, to entertain Jesus. Running around, oh, what will I cook for the master? She will run and they, you know, get oruku, oba, special, you know, pancake, and then the mangala, special, you know, goodies, condiment, in order to garnish a wonderful delicacy for Christ Jesus. He will even put what? You know, all the drinks, even ever wine, dove wine, and even paraclete water, pure water. All of them, they are there for Christ to enjoy. And all of a sudden, oh, Martha was no longer comfortable, because Mary was at the feet of Jesus Christ, hearing the message, sharing the word of God with Christ. And the mother ran to Christ and said, oh Christ, does it not hurt you that my sister has left the whole work only for me? And Christ told Martha, mother, you're worrying so much about, you're worrying for so many things, but one thing is most important, and Mary has chosen the better part. What is that thing that is important? Christ Jesus Christ is important. That is the most important thing in your life. Holiness is the most important thing in your life. Life of sacrifice is the most important thing in your life. Because the scripture says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and every other thing will be added unto it. The Bible, the Chinia Kagina Benu. Oh!
We are your children of mercy, on your people. We are your children of mercy, on your people.
Jesus.
Have mercy on your people. Have mercy on your people. But now we are your children. Mercy on your people.
Surrender yourself.
Mercy, have mercy on your people.
Baba, what you Onye ọbụna n'ebe a ọbara ukwu ebe ga-atụsa gị. Banye n'ekpere, banye n'ekpere, banye n'ekpere. Ọ bụrụ na ịchọta Chineke n'udo nzuzo oke, ifeife ga-eme na ndụ gị n'ọnwa a. Moment of intimacy.
Ike n'onwe ya, agụụ na-eche mba Chukwu. Anyị tọgbọrọ n'ukwu obe gị, wee na-arịọ kwa mara gị. Ụzọ ọbụla si mejọ gị, onye nwe gbaghara. Ụzọ niile si mejọ gị, biko, biko gbaghara. Hei, iyi ayọ Chukwu, esi ya ya.
Yeah.